cases are a really important function within NVivo. Cases are your units of analysis. So if you're working with social data, for example, they could be your interview participants or the organisations you're working with. They're essentially containers that let you keep everything to do with a person, a thing, or a place together. So if we take the interviewee Barbara, for example, everything that she says in her interview or in the survey will be coded to Barbara the case. All of that data is kept in one place thanks to cases. We might not need cases for all files. If we look up here, I've mocked up a couple of documents. On the right-hand side, there's a journal article. This is all authored by the same person and published in the same place. Cases aren't really useful in this context, and we might be better looking at file classifications. But if we look at the document on the left, we can see this is an interview. There's dialogue between two people, an interviewer and an interviewee. With human eyes, it's really easy to see that this is a dialogue between two people. We can see the interviewer is emboldened and the participant sits below. For NVivo, however, NVivo cannot tell who said what. It just sees text. This is where cases come in to help label pieces of data to individual cases, such as a person. If, for example, we create a case for Barbara and we code everything that she has said to that case, the case serves as that one container that keeps all of her words together. Cases work very well with other forms of coding. So as you start to code your document up for themes, in this case, environment, economy, community, and phishing, those exact same codes also overlap with that case. Let's look at this in practice in NVivo. I'm going to open up Barbara's interview. Just as we saw in the diagram, it's a dialogue between Henry, the interviewer, and Barbara, the participant. I'm going to create Barbara as a case and code everything she said to it. To do this, I'm going to go to the Cases folder by clicking on Cases and then choosing the Cases subfolder. We have the option to create subfolders if we wish. I'm going to right-click in List View and choose New Case. And this case is going to be Barbara. As soon as I click OK, the case, Barbara, loads on the left-hand side in List View and is now available for use. To code to my new case, all I need to do is highlight and drag and drop. I can very quickly go through this document, finding all of the references that Barbara has said, highlighting them and dragging and dropping them into this case. I'm also aware that some students don't like dragging and dropping, or they might find it a little bit difficult to do, particularly if you've got a trackpad. So let's look at a different way. I can do the same highlighting, and this time I can choose to right click and then code selection. In the list that opens under cases, I can see Barbara and I can code selection to Barbara. As soon as I've done this, you'll also notice it loads in the recent codes list here, so I can right click and choose Barbara the case there. All of these approaches are interchangeable and all do the same job. You can quickly see this does take some time, so you'll be relieved to know that there is an automated way to do this, which will be shown in the next video, as we look at how to do auto-coding to cases by speaker name. But for now, we can see that this document's done. And so this gives me two versions of Barbara's interview. I have this dialogue here in the file itself, which is stored under interviews. If I click, it'll open this file, and I can see the conversation between Henry and Barbara. However, if I go to cases and open Barbara the case, I can see just a container full of the words that Barbara has spoken. This is particularly useful if you have multiple documents or interviews to do with one individual. Even though you might have multiple files, it lets everything come together in one place. We can also add attributes to each case, for example specifying Barbara's age, employment, and her gender, and this will be shown in a later video.